Straight crack spitting.
What's going on, y'all? Appreciate y'all for being back here with another episode of the Fit Life Podcast. Only on the Buck Bandit Podcast Network. You already know, man. We dropping that heat, that fire. All I got to do is ask y'all one thing. Just give me one. Do me one favor. All y'all got to do is hit that subscribe button. Hit that notification bell. That's two things I like. Subscribe button and notification bell. Stay locked in and tapped into what we got going on over here because major moves is being made. So make sure y'all want to stay tapped in and locked into what's going on so y'all don't get left. You know what I mean? You look up a couple weeks later, shit then took off, and now you got to go back and watch everything we did in the past 2 weeks. So make sure y'all stay tuned in. And the best way to do that is to subscribe and hit that notification bell. So with all that being said, once again, I appreciate y'all for being here. Another week of the Fit Life Podcast. Summer is upon us. Damn near, it's been hot as shit out here. So it's like the summer is upon us for real. So let's get into this fit life. Let's talk a little bit. Quote of the week. You know I like to give y'all quote of the week. And this week's quote is, you don't have to be extreme, just be consistent. You don't gotta be extreme. We don't gotta do shit, you know what I mean, to go all out and go all crazy. I mean, but we'll get into that on another episode about going all out. But you don't got to go all out and go all crazy and fucking do shit to the extreme. Just be consistent with what you're trying to do, and you're going to be all right. And that lead me into a Bruce Lee quote that about consistency that always stuck out to me. Bruce Lee said, I don't fear the man who does 10,000 different kicks one time. He said, I fear the man who does one kick 10,000 times. So, like I said, don't be extreme. Just be consistent. Do that same kick 10,000 times. You know what I mean? You're going to be better than somebody practicing 10,000 kicks. So let's get right into this episode.
Yeah, you know what it is, the kid, Buck Bandit Reno. And I'm here to let y'all know the opportunity is here, man. Buck Bandit Podcast Network now is a Buck Bandit Podcast Network. So if you out there, you looking to shoot your podcast, you don't got a place to shoot it. You don't got video equipment, video editor. You don't got audio equipment, audio editor, lights, microphones. Don't worry about none of that because we'll handle that. You know, hit me up at Buck Bandit Reno on Instagram or Buck Bandit Podcast on Instagram and find out how you can get your own podcast here on the Buck Bandit Podcast Network, man. What are you waiting for? You in the house doing it? You still doing it off your phone? You doing lives? Forget all that. If you in the tri-state area, you in Philadelphia, come get your podcast shot here, man. Hit me up. Once again, at Buck Bandit Reno on Instagram, at Buck Bandit Podcast on Instagram, or you can email me at buckbanditstudio@gmail.com. Let's get it, man.
This is episode 5. 5 episodes in already. So let's get right into it. We're going to talk about ways exercise can help you. Ways that, you know what I mean, you can actually see some progress from exercising. So one I want to talk about, the first thing I want to talk about is the mental benefits. Like the benefits you get in your mental just from working out. And this is scientifically proven, by the way. So this ain't just me saying some shit that happened to me. Even though a lot of this shit did happen to me, and I can feel the effects of it, but this shit is scientifically proven. This is fucking studies from Harvard and all these fucking universities, and they came up with these studies. So I thought I'd just bring them to light. But the first mental benefits about working out is it reduces anxiety. You know how we be anxious about doing stuff. You might have a rough week coming up, a rough day, whatever. If you go to the gym, it reduces that anxiety, I guess, because your body is in motion and you lifting heavy shit and you sweating. Your body don't have time to think about shit that's going on outside of the gym. You know what I mean? Like, so it reduces that anxiety, that sense of anxiousness that you got to pay this bill or this ain't going right or you ain't where you want to be necessarily in your life. You know what I mean? We all go through that from time to time. But when you working out, it's something about going to that next level, about, you know, getting rid of that energy that you don't think about that shit. Like, and when you do think about it in that state, it's like, all right, it ain't as deep as I thought I was. I'm going to figure it out. Like, so that's one mental benefit. Another thing is it reduces depression and negative moods. Like, for me, when I'm going to the gym, like, I don't necessarily think about Maybe if it's leg day, I think about how bad the workout going to be, because I fucking hate leg. That's one thing I dislike is fucking leg day. But that my depression, like, because I had my my stints of, you know, going through depressed moods and feeling like, you know, life beating you down and shit just ain't going right. You go to the gym, man, you getting that next rep in, you doing that last mile running, you know, letting that energy out. It just make you feel refreshed. It's not one time that I went to the gym that when I was coming out, I didn't feel better than when I went in. Like, it always seemed like it's just a weight off your shoulder. It gives you energy to tackle them hard situations. I'm not saying just because you go to the gym, life going to be fucking sweet and peachy and you ain't going to never have to go through no adversity or nothing, because that'd be bullshit. That'd be me lying through my teeth. But it give you a sense of, damn, I just went through this hard-ass leg workout today. I ain't worried about nothing. You know what I mean? Life going to throw at me that I didn't just throw at myself, because I didn't want to fucking go do this. I did it anyway. I feel better. So now this challenge, this problem that I'm finding myself up against, it's going to be way easier to deal with just to process it mentally. Because most of the time, when we think about shit, it's either way worse or way better than what it really is. Like, our minds are that creative. Like, when you think about some shit bad that's going to happen, 9 times out of 10, when you finally face the situation, it was way worse in your head than it actually was in real life. You know what I mean? Like, so our minds will play tricks on us like that. And once you get into the routine of constantly working out and getting rid of that energy and actually putting your body in motion and in a fitness setting, it gives you that confidence to know that you can face any situation and come out better than what you went in. So that was a little bit of the mental benefits. I got a little bit more. So another mental benefit is it reduces the stress. You know what I mean? And like I just said before, it gives you the ability to cope with the stress. You know what I mean? So just for me, like I said, like when you go into the situation, like the gym, you go into the situation, it's going to be tough. You're going to be, but when you come out of that situation, you feel way better. Like, that's with anything in life. You going into this new area of life, or you got a promotion and you don't know how shit going to go and how your former coworkers are now going to be under you and you're going to have to boss them around. Like, you might have some anxiety towards that. You might be stressed out towards that. But just knowing that you can solve the problem, knowing that you can make it through, just knowing that there is a way out and knowing that it's not going to be as bad as you thought, is always gives you a heads up. And when once you come out of it, you always going to feel way better than when you went in. And the last mental benefit, one of my favorites, because I've been slacking on this for the past couple weeks, and I really gotta sit down and do my schedule over and really map out how my weeks are going to go, because this mental benefit right here is my fucking all-time favorite. Get better sleep, because I don't know about any of y'all out there. That's one of my favorite pastimes. I love going to fuck to sleep. Let me sleep for 12 hours. I'm good. I love sleeping. So working out helps you with your sleep tremendously. Like, you sleep way better. I know I get a deeper sleep on the nights that I go to the gym. Like, I'll get a deeper sleep, which means I'll wake up better rested, well rested. Like, you know how, and it's crazy, like, because I don't know how we know it if we're technically asleep. But you know when you get a bad night's sleep, you wake up just be like, man, I still feel tired. I don't feel like I got enough rest. Like, why is that? Because that's 9 times out of 10, we didn't do nothing throughout the day. We didn't woke up late, stayed up later, and we got some shit on our mind. So when we think, when it's time for our body to finally rest, our mind is still awake. I know y'all go through this. I go through it. We all go through it. Like, you be going through some shit in life and it'd be hard for you to fall asleep. When you get on a regular workout routine, I promise you, I probably stay up for about 10 minutes, 15 minutes at the longest before it don't take me long to go to sleep. I'll fall right to sleep every time because my body has to reset itself. I didn't work out all that energy. I didn't went through my day. I didn't deal with some challenges. I didn't, you know what I mean? And now my body is like, all right, now it's time to go to sleep. My mind don't race. I lay down, my mind be done. 10, 15 minutes, I'm right out. Wake up around 6, 7 hours later, and I'll be well rested. I won't even need the whole 8. But That's a mental benefit that we really got to pay attention to, because without sleep, it's going to be hard to do damn near anything. Like, if any of us, whoever, I'm pretty sure all of us have stayed up a whole night, a whole day, 24 hours, and you just feel like shit. Once that crash hits you, that shit is like one of the worst things in the world, and that shit is very, very detrimental to your health. So getting better sleep is another major benefit. And like I said, you wake up well rested and you have that energy. And as we all know, energy is what run the world. If you ain't got the energy to do it, you ain't gonna do it. Like, when we say I don't feel like shit, that's energy. You know what I mean? So just be mindful of that. Like, when you working out, you'll get better sleep and you'll have better energy. Another benefit, just point number two, some more benefits. I want to talk about like the health benefits of shit, like the health benefits of actually working out. Well, we all pretty much know what's the main reason why people want to work out. They want to lose weight. They want to get in shape. And that's actually a health benefit, because if we go back in time, most people wasn't obese. I don't believe it was anybody obese back then, because we had to do too much physical labor. Like, the women was at home and they was taking care of whatever, the cave or whatever, the hut, whatever, before it was houses. Like, and the men was out hunting. And sometimes the men might have been out there hunting for a couple days. Like, you don't just go out there and be like, I'm gonna go hunt, and you come back with food. That shit ain't always happen like that. So controlling your weight is something that is very healthy. We look at somebody, I guess it's a slender build, and we say that they're unhealthy. Or we look at somebody who has a heavier build and say that they're unhealthy, when it's all a case-by-case basis. It's all about your blood levels and your sugar levels and your metabolism. Like, all of that coincides with what is your healthy weight. But being overweight is definitely something that's not healthy, has never been healthy, because that what being overweight means is just means that your organs are inflamed. It means that you have inflammation in your organs, and that was what causes heart disease and high blood pressure and diabetes. Like, all of that is directly connected to inflammation. So if we can just control our weight just by constantly working out and constantly regulating our body and constantly being on a sleep routine, constantly being on an eating routine, you can regulate that and actually have your weight working for you instead of working against you. So that's one thing that I believe everybody know, but we don't know the science behind it. So it's hard to actually understand it and break it down. And anything that you don't understand, you're going to stay away from. That's why it's so important to understand this shit. Like, the reason why most people don't invest in stocks, because they don't understand it. If you don't understand the shit, you're not going to fucking do the shit. So it's so important to understand why you should, why your weight should be helping you and not hurting you. Another health benefit, like I said, I just went into, it reduces heart disease. Heart disease, and basically, I believe like the first 10 major causes of death in the United States are all related to what I was saying, your body weight and basically your heart. And so if we know that exercising could eliminate most of those things that I'm talking about, then it'll make it easier to go. It'll give you that fuel and that fire to actually get up and say, all right, yeah, this week I'm going to the gym at least 4 times a week. You know what I mean? This week I'm going to go on at least a couple walks. This week I'm going to make sure I don't eat that extra slice of pizza, whatever it is. Like, but just make sure that you being mindful of your health and the benefits and the disadvantages of everything you do throughout your days, from far as what you eat, how you sleep, just as far as your exercise and routine. Like, because just because you don't go to the gym don't mean you can't work out. Just because you ain't go for your walk don't mean you can't, you know, go get some sun. Like, it's so many different ways to actually be healthy and be mindful of your goals and of your challenges. But we just have to be intentional. That's all. If we're intentional and we're aware of everything that we're doing, then it'll make it that much easier to stay on task and stay on track. And the last health benefit I want to talk about is, It helps, it, when you working out regularly, it does something to make you always want to strive for more. Like, because if you've been working out, you've been lifting 20-pound dumbbells for the past couple weeks, it's only a matter of time for you to get to them 25s, because the 20s are going to start to feel light. You're going to be like, oh, shit, let me try these. It's something in that that it keeps you sharp in thinking and learning, and your judgment skills get better as you evolve in your fitness journey. And this is all proven. Like, this is not me talking. Like, these are proven facts. Y'all can go look up these studies of people who work out and people who don't work out, and just their ability to learn and take in new information and judge situations is way different than somebody who doesn't. Because, like I said, when you work out, it does something to your mental, and your mental is everything. That's why I started with the first episode with mindset. Your mental is everything, because once you can wrap your head around it, like I said, if you don't understand it, you're not going to do it. Once you can wrap your head around a subject and you actually can understand more of it, it gets you into this mode of where you want to understand more. Like, because the more you know, the more you realize you don't know, if that makes sense. Like, the more you dig into a subject, the more you realize you have to dig into this subject to actually grasp a concept of this subject, because shit gets into a rabbit hole. Once you realize, oh, shit, if I eat better, then it's going to make me feel better. Once I feel better, then I'm going to sleep better. Once I sleep better, then I'm going to act better. Once I'm going to act better, then I can live better. Like, once you realize that cycle, you like, oh, shit, okay, so this does affect that. And every action has a reaction. So I'm going to be real intentional about what I'm doing and how I'm living. So that's the last health benefit, man. It really helps you think and learn better than the average person who doesn't do any physical exercises, which ultimately means you're not doing any mental exercises. And last point is the physical benefits of working out. The physical benefits, as we all probably know, you get stronger, you know what I mean? You look better, you look more cut up, your clothes fit better. And that's actually a good thing, because it builds confidence. Like, one thing about your confidence is you gain confidence by keeping your word to yourself, not what you necessarily say to anybody else. If you tell yourself, I'm going to wake up early, and you don't wake up early, nobody know that you said that to yourself. Only you know. So you start to, it chips away at your confidence. But once you start saying you're going to do stuff and you actually do it, just say, I'm going to go to the gym. You can actually go to the gym, walk in and walk out. Your confidence is going to be a little bit higher because you did what you told yourself you were going to do. So we have to understand that that benefit is one of the major benefits, because you can't hardly do anything without confidence. LeBron James can't win as many chips as he win if he don't think that he gonna win a chip before he even gets to there. Like, you have to wrap your head around it first. Another physical benefit is, I talked about it a little bit, but I'm gonna go a little bit deeper. It improves your brain function. Like, our brains are a muscle, is people probably don't wanna admit it or just don't know, but your brain is a muscle. Your brain can grow, your brain can shrink, your brain is a muscle. So you have to constantly be working it out. And if you doing physical exercises, your brain is taking in that information. It's your, what do they call it on the computer? Your RAM, your whatever, is random access memory, something like that. But that is what our brain is. Our brain is our RAM. So everything that we do, our brain is taking notes. Oh, he said he was going to get up early. He didn't get up early. Okay, so we don't do what we say we're going to do. Your brain is taking notes of that. So if you could flip that around, oh, he said we're going to do this. Okay, this time that he said he was going to do this, we normally do it. So now your brain is going to start to take notes, and it's going to start making your body do shit. Have any of us, I'm pretty sure we have, anybody here, if y'all like me, if any of us been trying to stop a habit or picked up a new habit or something, and you just find yourself somewhere and you be like, damn, how the fuck did I even get here? Or why did I even do this? I don't even remember doing this, because it was already in your RAM. So your brain knew, oh yeah, after you eat, you roll up an L and you sit there and you watch TV for an hour. So you gonna find yourself 45 minutes later with an L in your hand watching TV, and that shit was all unconscious fucking actions, because you did this shit so much that your brain was like, okay, body, this is the time we roll up, this is the time we chill and watch TV for an hour because we just ate. So if you can reverse that to say, all right, let me building good habits. Let me do some shit that's going to make my body do some shit the other way. You know what I mean? Like, let me, anytime I go to the store, I'm used to grabbing a salad. All right, now I'm going to grab a salad without even thinking about grabbing a salad. They sell burgers, but I never had a burger because every time I go there, I got a habit of getting a salad. And that's what my brain tells me to do every time I go there. So that's another physical benefit, is your brain function and how it helps you gain momentum in whatever direction you're going. And the last physical benefit I want to talk about is it makes you feel better. That's probably the most important for me. It makes you feel better, man. Like, you ain't going to feel good all the time. I don't give a fuck what. You can have a million, billion dollars living the life you want. At some point, you're going to be sitting on the beach with that drinking umbrella like, all right, what else is it? You know what I mean? It got to be something, because that's how we work as humans. We're not really fulfilled unless we're chasing something, or we're progressing, or unless we're working towards something. Like, is this a reason why most people, after they retire, they die in like 10 years? It's a reason behind that, because they don't feel as though they're not contributing to society no more. They don't have a purpose. They just sitting at home watching Judge Judy. Or like, it's only so long that your body is going to be like, well, we not working out, we not doing nothing, we just sitting here. Your body's going to deteriorate, because that's a universal law. Nothing can stay the same. You're either going to die or you're going to grow. That's a universal law. You cannot stay the same. So with that understanding, you know that if you're staying the same, if you still the same you were last year, you actually still in last year. You actually moved backwards. You're not the same. So just always know that when you working out and your physical is getting better and your feelings, and you more in tune with your emotions. I might do a episode about that too, emotional intelligence, because that shit is so important. Because if once you can feel better and you know what makes you get into a certain mood, you can kind of dictate your moods. You can be, all right, this makes me happy. Let me do this when I'm feeling down, so I know I can bring myself back up. So I ain't going to wrap y'all head off too much. I just wanted to give y'all, you know, couple more benefits of why it's good to work out and why we need to, you know what I mean, be intentional about it. So let me run it back from the top, do a quick recap, and we're gonna get out of here, man. Episode 5, once again, thank y'all for being here, but I'm gonna do a little recap of episode 5.
Yeah, you know what it is, the kid Buck Bandarino,
boy, Buck Bandit Pig,
and we the host of Buck Bandit Podcast, man.
Know,
and if you don't know, we on season 2, man. So if you ain't check us out, man, make sure you check us out, man.
Definitely make sure you check us out, man. Definitely on all streaming platforms. Get your podcast.
Alright, sir. Watch the videos on YouTube.
Right.
You know what I mean? We talk about everything from entertainment, sports, man, all the bullshit going down on the social media, everything.
You know what I mean? If y'all out there doing some crazy shit, don't be doing some crazy shit, yeah, but we gonna talk about it.
Yeah, yeah. And definitely you can come and watch me, your boy, win 95% of the arguments too, you know, because I always know everything,
yeah,
you know
what I mean? That's some bullshit. I win all the
fucking. He definitely gonna win.
The quote of the week is, you don't have to be extreme, just be consistent. Like I said, the Bruce Lee quote, he said, I do not fear the man who does 10,000 kicks once, but I fear the man who does one kick 10,000 times. Always keep that in mind when trying to be consistent. Point number one, mental benefits. It reduces anxiety, depression, and negative moods. If you want to get that negative energy up off you, go to the gym, do some workouts, start sweating. I guarantee you ain't even going to remember why you was negative in the first place, because you're going to be sweating, you're going to be tired. Shower off, you start your day, I guarantee you're going to feel a lot better. Another mental benefit is it reduces stress, and it improves your ability to cope with stress. Because once you get out of that situation, we all been through there. When that one situation, we ain't know how the fuck we was going to get out of it. We ain't know how we was going to get through it. But once we got to that other side, we felt better. That's the same thing with going to the gym. You don't want to go. You don't know how you going to get through this workout. But once you do it, you're going to feel better. And the last mental benefit I talked about was getting better sleep and getting that increased dose of energy. And sleep is one of the most important things to our health. Like, I thought it was food, I thought it was working out, I thought it, no, none of that is as important as sleep. You can fucking eat the best food, you can work out all the time, but if you only getting 3-4 hours of sleep, it's going to be a detriment to your gains. So always keep that in mind, get better sleep. And while I'm on that subject, make sure y'all check out my man Sean Stevenson book, Sleep Better, I believe what it's called. game changer. Make sure y'all check out, and while y'all at it, make sure y'all check out his podcast too, the Mental Health Show, I believe is what, the Model Health Show. Model Health Show. Make sure y'all check that out too with my man Sean Stevenson, because he's a goat in the lane of the mental health and far as getting better sleep. But point number two, health benefits. It helps you control your weight. That's what most people want to get in, work out for, to lose some weight and tone up. But controlling your weight actually has great benefits, because it stops that inflammation, which stops the top 10 reasons why most Americans die. Like, it's from fucking some shit that has to do with your weight and inflammation. Point number two on health benefits, it reduces your risk of a heart disease. A lot of this shit is heart disease. Diabetes, fucking high blood pressure. Most of that shit is because of your heart, and a lot of that shit got to do with your weight. So if you working out and you do it daily, something daily of just some stress to your body, some controlled stress, it's a game changer, because it'll actually help your heart pump that blood throughout your body and throughout your organs way fucking easier, and you can just get so many benefits from it. And the last health benefit is it helps your thinking, learning, and judgment skills get sharper as you age. So as you getting older, you know how some people disintegrate or they get worse as they get older? You can actually be getting older and getting better, because every day is a new day to learn, and every day is a new day to grow. And somehow going to the gym and seeing your body change and feeling different and getting the proper amount of sleep, your judgment skills, your learning, and your thinking get sharper. I can't explain it, but if the ones who know, if you know, you know. If you know, you know. So definitely want to be mindful of those health benefits. And the last point is the physical benefits. Excuse me. Last point is the physical benefits, which is it helps improve your brain function. It helps you with your memory. You know what I mean? It helps you gear yourself and towards the way you want to go, because it's real easy to get off track of something when you don't know where you want to go. As long as you know where you want to go, it's easy to stay on track. And of course, we all know you get stronger and improve your ability to do daily activities, going up and down the steps without getting tired and all that. And that's good. And the last physical benefit, which is one of my favorites, man, it helps you feel better. Who don't want to feel better? You know what I mean? Like, if you sick, you don't give a fuck about how much money in your bank account. You don't give it. Only thing you want to do is feel better. So that's the last physical benefit, is feeling better. And that's what this Fit Life shit is all about. It's about living better. It's about feeling better. And it's about doing better. And I gotta give y'all my new tagline that the boy Buck Mandarino came up with, man. It's the new tagline to the Fit Life podcast. We physically fit, we mentally fit, and we financially fit. So make sure y'all stay fit and make sure y'all stay tapped in. I appreciate y'all for being here. This has been another episode of the Fit Life podcast, only on the Buck Bandit Podcast Network. Make sure y'all tap in. Make sure y'all subscribe. Hit that notification bell. This is your host, the boy, Fit Buck Bandit, also known as Buck Bandit P. Appreciate y'all for being here. Until next time, Buck. Turn me up a little bit. Turn me up a little bit.